hacking can be, like all activities in human life, legal or illegal. But in fact, it's usually blurred.
There's all sorts of hats in hacker culture, right? So there's the white hats, and those are the good guys, right? And so a white hat hacker would be someone who, you know, kind of probed a computer system of a big company. If they found a hole, they wouldn't go very far through it, and then they would contact the company and, you know, give the company time to fix it. And then there's just the black hats. And the black hats generally are people these days who are trying to steal credit cards or break into your PayPal account or get into your email account. You know, the end game is just money.
The black hats are people that break into systems. When we started doing this, just looking at researching software and uncovering vulnerabilities and publishing tools that let people hack into systems using those vulnerabilities, people tried to label us as black hats and said, but wait a minute, we're not breaking into systems. We're not like these guys. You can use these tools for good or you can use them for bad. We think you white hat people should use our tools to figure out what systems have the vulnerabilities. But of course they didn't do that. So we had to come up with this new term, and we coined the term at the loft called gray hat, because we didn't want to wear a black or a white hat.
All hackers are gray hat hackers. People who present themselves as white hat hackers are gray hat hackers who are simply fudging the truth.
We got invited to speak at the Senate in 1998. The thing that was really exciting for us was they reached out to, you know, hackers. They reached out to us, they let us testify, you know, using our hacker names.
They'll be using their hacker names of Mudge, Weld, Brian Oblivion, Kingpin, Space Rogue, Tan, and Stefan.
One of my colleagues, Mudge, had been doing research on how the different parts of the internet connect to each other, how, you know, Sprint connects to AT&T, and found a vulnerability in the way that the major interconnection points between the big network providers, he found a vulnerability where he could sever those connections. And so I think he really scared them when he said, you know, we could take down the internet in 30 minutes.
I'm informed that you think that within 30 minutes, the seven of you could make the internet unusable for the entire nation. Is that correct?
That's correct. Actually, one of us with just a few packets. We've told a few agencies about this. It's kind of funny because we think that this is something that the various government agencies should be actively going after. We know the Department of Defense just did a very large investigation into what's known as denial of service attacks against the infrastructure. In our various day jobs, we contributed a large portion of the information to that actual investigation. Much to our chagrin, the learnings from it were instantly classified, which we were giving them largely public information.
There was a few people in the back of the room from the NSA that came up afterwards and like, you got to tell us about this. And of course we did.
I look at you guys as the white hats in this whole thing. Yeah, I think your motivation, as far as I know, is excellent.